It is game two of the Eastern Conference Finals with the Orlando Magic going against the Cleveland Cavaliers. Hi, everybody. I'm Marv Albert along with Doug Collins. We'll be joined in a moment by Craig Sager working the sidelines right here. Let's check out the McDonald's starting lineups for the Magic up front. Rashard Lewis, Hedo Turkoglu, and Dwight Howard, all three, came up with stellar performances in game one. At the guards, the rookie Courtney Lee and Rafer Alston. Here are the Cavaliers looking to even up the series if one. LeBron James with that playoff career high 49 points Wednesday night. LeBron with Anderson Barajal, Zydrunas Ilgauskas in the backcourt, Devontae West and Mo Williams. The Cavs need both West and Williams to pick it up at the offensive end. And Doug, how do you size up the keys for tonight's game two?
Well, Mark, to me, the big story is points in the paint, fast break, and three-point shooting. This is where Orlando has caused Cleveland all kinds of problems. In the regular season, they were plus 30 points a game in these three, plus 16 in game one. So they're going to have to do a better job. And how about the matchups? The Magic starting front court, 67 points. Rashard Lewis was terrific. 12 in the fourth quarter, hit his last seven shots, including the game winner. 26 points in the paint by Dwight Howard, and 14 assists from Hedo Turkoglu. 7 in the fourth quarter. The bench, 25-5 for the Magic. Mikal Peters had 13 of those 25 points, so the better bench play. And then to me, the mindset. Martin talked about it. A must win for Cleveland, but for the Magic, can they stay hungry? If they did down 15 or 16 points like they did in game one, will they have that same fight to try to win game two?
And that a major concern of Orlando head coach Stan Van Gundy, who told us earlier it's human nature after winning game one. If they do fall back, it may not be the same sense of urgency knowing that they can settle because they're going back to Orlando tied at one with the loss here tonight.
Well, Mark, they had that problem. They went in Boston, won game one in Boston Garden. They had a 28-point lead in that game, got down to 5. They won the game, and then came out in game two and gave up 112 points and played very soft. Mark, the one thing I've learned being in the NBA a long time, never give up a playoff game. You have to treat every game as you got to try to win it.
And as you see, LeBron with his traditional pregame routine to get this crowd going. Sell out as usual here at Quicken Loans Arena. 20,562. The Cavaliers at home during the regular season, 39-2. They had won their first four at home in the postseason. So these fans were really just amazed that their home team could actually lose a game as they did the other night.
Marv, you could feel as Orlando was coming back how quiet it got in here. And when Rashard Lewis hit that three, I mean, you could feel the fans like, uh-oh, this is going to be a series.
And Orlando, a very good road team. They'll jump it up again. Apparently someone tried to steal the tap. Monty McCutcheon, crew chief, Bill Kennedy, Tom Washington are the officials. On the road during the regular season, Orlando 27-14, and they have won 5 road games in the postseason. Cavaliers control. This is Williams trying to use the screen, and Mo Williams comes up way short. Deflected out, last touch by Howard.
Now, game one, the start was not the problem for the Cleveland Cavaliers. They got off to a great start. LeBron James came out passing. Anderson Barajal had the first 6 points of the game. They were actually out quickly, and then Orlando really picked it up as the game went on. I think they're trying to figure out here whether the shot clock should recycle, exactly what should happen here.
Well, the Cavaliers are claiming that it did touch the rim, and the officiating crew said no. So the ball was deflected out of bounds, and the possession continues. Here is LeBron popping it back out, sets up West for three. And rebounded by Howard.
And Orlando wants to push the pace of the game. They want to look for quick threes in transition. They do not want to play in a half-court game.
Magic not hitting their threes in the first half, but came out on fire from downtown in the second half. This is Courtney Lee, played by a combination of Barajal and Williams. Lee with the setup. Howard stripped from behind, not able to hit on the recovery. West gets it down low. James with the left hand is fouled. Fouled by Turkoglu.
But Dwight Howard had a dunk on that play. Courtney Lee had great penetration, and he got very careless with it. Like he missed him, handled the first one, and then Delonte West, beautiful hands, knocked that loose. So instead of a dunk there by Dwight Howard, it turns into two missed field goals and a run out for the Cleveland Cavaliers.
LeBron the other night, 6 of 10 at the line, so he did struggle. Although 20 of 30 from the field for 49 points, and the rest of the team puts up 57.
And the four free throws that he missed in the game, 3 of those were in the fourth quarter. Margaret, he started cramping and was getting tired. And even hit by his own admission, he said, look, I could not simulate in practice what it is playing in front of 22,000 people. He cramped up and got dehydrated, and it really hurt his team at the end of the game.
Turgolo being played here by West at the start. Fires a three, rebounded by Ilgauskas.
That's the same matchups they started with. West on Turkoglu. They had Ray Burleson being played by LeBron James.
James again taking to the rim. Ilgauskas able to chase it down. Lee contesting for it. Kept alive though by the Cavaliers. Ilgauskas down low now. Barichal wide open. And rebounded by Howard.
Well, Orlando will live with that shot. Barichal shooting about a 16-foot jump shot.
There's Howard going at Ilgauskas with a running hook.
Sort of a replay of game one. When he faces up Ilgauskas, Ilgauskas just does not have the foot speed or the strength to play him. Mark, as I said, he had 26 points of his 30 in the paint. That is a big trouble at that matchup for the Cleveland Cavaliers.
As you touched on, the Cavaliers must get strong games from the backcourt. Mo Williams, Delonte West. Nice move by Ilgauskas. Delonte West, the other night, missed 9 of his last 11, 5 of his last 6 from downtown. And Mo Williams, who shooting just 42% during the postseason, quite a drop-off from his regular season shooting. Good job by Barichal on Lewis. And Howard is fouled.
So one of the things you're seeing here early in this game that's a little bit of a danger sign for Cleveland is their guards are getting in the lane. Amar, that's twice now that Courtney Lee has gotten inside. This time a little back cut that LeBron just took his eyes off of him. And now that's 3 times that Dwight Howard has caught that ball at the basket. One time he scored, the other time he missed an easy one, and now he's going to shoot 2 free throws. So he's getting very deep post catches.
Mo Williams called for the foul. Dwight Howard just 59% at the line during a regular season, and the playoffs right around 62.
And Marv, I think when they looked at the stat sheet after the game and you look at these numbers in game one, 2 free throw attempts for Dwight Howard. And with him shooting free throws like you talked about, they have got to foul him around that basket. Now, maybe it might not be Z and Barichal, but when Wallace comes in the game, some of these guys have to take some fouls and make him shoot free throws, not let him dunk the ball.
Lewis with the steal. We're talking about that earlier with Cleveland head coach Mike Brown, who said he wants Ben Wallace, when he does come in, to wrap up Howard more effectively, put him at the line. Lewis, a wild shot, rebounded by Ilgauskas. And we may also see Mike Brown go deeper into his bench for a guy who's not played much, Sasha Popovic. That counts, and the foul! West with the bucket, and he will go to the line to foul on Courtney Lee.
It looks to me like Cleveland is being much more aggressive to start this game. I thought, Marv, they finished the second half jump shot happy, and especially with Dwight Howard having 4 fouls going into that fourth quarter, they shot a lot of jump shots. A lot of times when you see that with a team, that's a sign of fatigue. You get a little tired, and sometimes you subconsciously take the easy way out and you take that jump shot. You're seeing them go to the basket, and they want to get Dwight Howard in foul trouble. The other night, his fouls came on the offensive, and he had 2 early, quick offensive fouls.
Here's a double on Howard, and it's stolen by West. 3 Magic players back. James goes right at Lewis.
So there's a change and adjustment from the other night. That was a big-on-big double team. Barichal left Rashard Lewis and double teamed to cause the turnover. Here's Ray Burleson with a jump shot. So You talk about adjustments. They went down and double-teamed on catch on Dwight Howard with Vic Varejao and left Rashard Lewis at the top of the key. So that means Cleveland was going to have to be scrambling in their defense.
And we're seeing more of Zagrunas down low in the post. And a hook that just could get over the outstretched hand of Dwight Howard.
I think it's a great strategy. The other night, Dwight Howard didn't have to guard him in the post. Zagrunas Ilgauskas had one field goal in the second half. You've got to make Howard work on the defensive end as well.
Turgler with a hook pass to Howard, slapped away by James. And Alston called for the foul. Oh, Williams didn't like the late hit by Howard, threw the ball at Howard, and that'll be a technical
foul.
Yeah,
I haven't seen it called yet, though. That's got to be a technical. I mean, he threw the ball at him. And that's got to be a technical. I didn't see anybody call it. I think maybe Tommy Washington, Billy Kennedy, I think maybe called it back here one back.
His first, third team foul this quarter.
I can't believe it. They have not called a technical on that.
That is.
I mean, that's a clear technical foul.
Unless all three guys were not looking in that direction, I don't know how you cannot call a technical foul.
That's unreal. That's amazing that they get out of this.
And the crowd reacts. It is being shown up above on the big video screen. Oh, Williams with the circular rear picked up on a switch by Howard. And hits the jumper. Mo Williams did not shoot well in game one. Just 6 of 19 from the field. Alston with the runner. The Cavaliers very active here at the start. West gets the ball. And the foul. Cleveland in front, 15-5. And Delonte West is headed to the line.
Well, you're seeing him get it in the open court. A lot of times, teams that run don't like to be run against. And the Orlando Magic are not getting back in transition. We've seen Mo Williams on the break. We've seen now Delonte West. We've seen LeBron James. So the fast break points right now, Cleveland really looking to push that ball. And an off-the-ball foul, Varejao will be shooting a free throw.
Alston called for the foul, so the field goal by West was good, but Varejao cannot make it into a three-point play. 14 fouls for the Magic here at the start, and Stan Van Gundy takes a timeout. On a 61-degree night here in Cleveland, Ohio, time for Gatorade around the cooler. Let's check in with Craig Sager. Craig.
Well, concern for the Cavs tonight is to keep LeBron James hydrated. Remember Wednesday night at the end of the game, he leapt off the court suffering some cramps from dehydration. He immediately went to the trainer's room. He was given plenty of fluids. He was able to attend the post-game press conference. Yesterday, he felt fine. However, today, to make sure everything went well, the ball boys had 3 bottles of fluid for his pregame ritual. As soon as that was over, 3 hours before tip, he drank those 3 bottles within 2.5 minutes. Athletic trainer Max Benton has plenty of fluids on the bench, and he will be monitored throughout the game.
He also tweaked his left knee, Doug, on a drive to the basket, and then he went down with cramps at the final buzzer.
Well, you know, remember Mike Brown had to take a timeout with about 3 minutes to go in the game to let LeBron get some rest. So definitely fatigue was a factor after eight full days off in game one.
Here's Turgler with the running hook. Rebounded by Howard, and he puts it down.
That's the Dwight Howard we saw in game one. He's a great offensive rebounder, averaging almost 5 offensive rebounds in the playoffs. So you've got to try to keep your body on him. They changed the matchups now. They have Rashard Lewis on Ilgauskas. Now they're running over Howard, so they're switching that matchup as the Cavs bring the ball up the floor.
And Anthony Johnson, who played very well in game one, has come on for way for Alston. He is defending on Williams. Williams with the spin, fires one up, and Ilgauskas not able to save it. And just moments ago, we're talking about the play where Mo Williams was upset, took that late hit from Dwight Howard, threw the ball at Howard, and normally that's an automatic technical foul. Nothing was called. And Doug, you went over to the official, Bill Kennedy.
And he said none of us saw it. Yeah. So they're obviously, we're all looking at something else, a break that time to get away from that technical.
And here comes James all the way for the stop. Rashard Lewis wisely stepped away.
Yeah, because that's going to be a 3-point play. You're not going to stop him once he gets that kind of head of steam up with his power, so you might as well give him the basket to get back.
Here's Howard, slapped away, handled by West. Cavaliers have come out with lively legs here at the start. Williams hit on a reach-in by Turkoglu. And for Turkoglu, that's his second.
Well, LeBron James in the playoffs averages almost 7 points a game on the fast break. Actually, a little over 7. So when he gets in the open court, you're not going to be able to stop that. The powerful finish. And Marv, they're very sharp here to start this game as they were in game one. Let's see if they finish much better than they did the other night.
Yes, in game one, they led by as many as 16, had that 15-point lead at the half. Turkoglu, as I mentioned, picked up the foul. He goes to the bench. Orlando now over the foul limit, and Michael Petras, who has played very well in the postseason, has come on for Turkoglu.
Now, actually, when Stan Van Gundy went to his bench the other night, I thought Anthony Johnson and Michael Petras, when they came in, I thought both of those guys really did a nice job, especially when Dwight Howard was on the bench in that third quarter with a couple fouls, or four fouls. They came in and actually cut in to that Cleveland lead, got it to four at the end of the third quarter, and then had that beautiful fourth quarter finish.
Anthony Johnson did a nice job defensively, hit two of three, 5 points in his 15 minutes. Varejão called on the second team foul for the Cavs.
That's the one play that Mike Brown said that he wishes he would have done a better job adjusting to the other night, is that screen roll with Rashard Lewis coming across and then fanning out to the corner. He had three straight jump shots.
There's Johnson over Ilgauskas. Anthony Johnson, a seasoned veteran of the postseason. He's made the playoffs 7 of his 12 years in the NBA with 4 different teams.
And Mark, when Jamaire Nelson went down, you know, for a while he was going to have to be their starting point guard and play 30 plus minutes. He just was not going to be able to do that, so they were able to get the trade for great for Alston.
Williams too strong with that shot. And Nelson had an all-star season, suffered a dislocated right shoulder halfway through the season. Here's Howard going on the double team by Cleveland, and he was fouled. Took a hit to the forehead from LeBron James. And the other day, Jamaire Nelson made the statement that he feels he can still return during the playoffs if Orlando is able to advance, and general manager Ole Smith said there's no way.
Absolutely. I mean, that's when your competitive spirit gets in the way of your health. And right now, the way Orlando's playing, there's no need to put him out there. I love what Ole Smith said. Yeah, he's practicing against air right now. There's no bodies that he's playing against. So.
The Ryder national coverage of the NBA playoffs continues tomorrow on ABC Game 3 between the Lakers and the Nuggets. Denver executing down the stretch last night at Staples in LA. They tie that series at 1. We'll be back with you Sunday right here on TNT. Game 3 of the Cavs and the Magic from Orlando, starting 8 o'clock Eastern time. Dwight Howard misses on both. And Monday on ESPN, Game 4 between the Lakers and the Nuggets.
Mark, you can already see Dwight Howard has taken 4 free throws in the first quarter, 1 of 4, attempted only 2 all of Game 1. And here's Mo Williams, and this is the Mo Williams that was the right-hand man of LeBron James in the regular season when he made the All-Star team, average about 18 a game, shot 44% from that three-point line.
Johnson. So once again, Anthony Johnson knocks down the jumper. Coming up on 4 minutes to go in this opening quarter, the Cavaliers with a 20-11 lead. Trying to tie the series at 1. Here's Williams, not a good shot. And rebounded by Howard.
Mark, you made a great point. That's 2 bad shots that Mo Williams has taken. And when you're struggling, you want to make sure you get high-quality shots.
Johnson with the step, sets it up for Petras for 3. And he continues to hit the long-range shot.
And all of a sudden, the Magic are back to within 6. That's the way this team plays. They spread you out. They penetrate. When they're up 15, they're not safe. And when you're up 15, you're not safe.
For the Magic, their first successful three-pointer. And pass could not be saved by Williams.
Defense. Defense.
Lewis off the ball fake. There's Howard. Foul is called on Varejao. It's called a block. It is team foul number four on the Cavs. Second on Varejao. And Howard heads back to the line.
Dwight Howard going to the basket once again. It looked like Varejao was in that verticality. His hands were up straight. And this, a lot of people felt that the foul on Dwight Howard the other night against LeBron James, that he was in sort of that same position when he got that foul and fouled out of the game.
And Mike Brown about to make some substitutions. Howard, one of five on at the line. Joe Smith and Sasha Pavlovich checking in. And Sasha Pavlovich, exciting, has played very little in the postseason. When the Cavaliers went to the finals 2 years back, he was in the starting lineup. Sasha, averaging during the regular season just 16 minutes a game.
Well, he's played 38 minutes total in these playoffs, Marv. And the interesting thing about it is LeBron James spoke up for him the other day, said, we might need Pavlovich. We were in the Cleveland locker room before the game, and who was sitting next to LeBron James in the locker room? Pavlovich getting an earful of like, look, I have talked about you getting in the game. I expect you to mentally be into this ball game. When you come in, you get your chance, because he's a very underrated defender. You can see he started, Marvin, you talked about, on that team that went to the finals. The thing with Pavlovich, he's a very talented player, and on occasion he'll drift. The game is easy for him. And in the playoffs, you have to be conscious and focused on every single play.
Foul on Petrus. Magic over the limit, so James at the line. What hurt Sasha Pavlovich last season was that contract holdout. Injuries also setting him back. Sasha in his fifth season with the Cavaliers after a year with Utah, and could be a key player coming off the bench.
But yeah, because LeBron James a lot of times moves to the four position. That's fine, but if he does that, who's going to play the three spot that has some size? And that was a problem the other night when Cleveland had to play two bigs.
A strong ball by Lee, but Ilgauskas may have gotten a piece of it. Courtney Lee is defending on Sasha Pavlovich. Ilgauskas with a series of moves and scores. He's off to a good start. 3 of 3 from the field, 5 rebounds.
And he's a rhythm player. If anybody gets hurt with a layoff, it's him, because he's a guy that needs this continual repetition as a big guy.
Slow start for Rashard Lewis. Similar story the other day, and then came on very strong in the second half. Brown wants Ilgauskas to go, and Howard then fires one from deep. And a foul. It is on Smith. Cavaliers are now over the foul limit. So free throws coming up. We're down to 2:18 left in this first quarter, and the Cavs are up by 9. They've led by as many as 11.
Mark, once again, a very slow start from Turkaloo Lewis, who you talked about. And tonight they're combined 0-4. They have no points. And in game one, they were 0-5 with only 1 point. So both of those guys got off to very slow starts. They had terrific second halves. But what you've seen right now is Anthony Johnson has come in, and Michael Petrus come in, and they have 8 points off the bench here. So once again, that bench coming in and giving them some points while their two star players have gotten up against the slow starts.
Anthony Johnson, 75% of the line during the regular season out of the College of Charleston. ...24-16 Cavaliers. Cleveland team that went 66-16 in the regular season, swept through the first two rounds, four straight over Detroit, four straight over Atlanta. West trying to get it back. He does. The James, shot clock down to 4. Now to 3. Smith off the fake.
24 seconds.
And it's a shot clock violation.
Well, Cleveland is really looking to drive that ball, drive and kick, and that was an excellent defensive possession by Orlando, really scrambling and doing a nice job to get the shot clock violation. So as good as Cleveland has played here in this first half, still Orlando hanging around in this first period.
Johnson and Lee up the guards, Howard, Petrus, and Lewis. Up front, here is Courtney Lee for three. Good box out by James, last touch by Lewis, the ball back to the Cavs. This is game two of the Eastern Conference Final. The scene will shift to Orlando for games three and four. We'll be there Sunday night and then next Tuesday, exclusively here on TNT. It all gets underway at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Just under a minute and a half to go in the first. West with room for three. Delonte West.
Well, you saw the rotation there. The defender comes to Pavlovich. He makes the extra pass. So just his presence out there, they had to guard him.
Ball deflected out by Pavlovich.
Checking in your Cavaliers. Replacing.
Look at his rotation now. The man guarding Pavlovich has to help out. Here's the rotation out of the corner. The extra pass. Delonte West, that's that hockey assist we always talk about that normally frees up that shooter. It's the second pass, not the first one out of the double team.
And Wallace has come on for Zdrinas Ogalskis. Leads with 6 points, six rebounds. Petrus, that three-pointer goes short. Here comes James. Final minute, first quarter. James met by Lee. Courtney Lee, the rookie from Western Kentucky. James shoots over him, way off. Johnson able to swing away. And it's last touch by the Cavs.
Orlando
has the full 24. We're down to 34 seconds to go in this first quarter.
Let's see if they run a little quick out of bounds play here to get a 2-for-1 possession.
Pass off the mark and backcourt violation.
Backcourt violation. Cavs ball.
So the Cavaliers take over with a 5-second differential between the game clock and shot clock. Cleveland 10 of 19 shooting here in the first quarter, while Orlando just 6 of 18.
In game one, they were 8 of 22 in the first quarter, so it sort of continued along the same lines of Cleveland off to the great start, Orlando getting out of the chute very slowly.
Pavlovich for three.
Yes!
On the assist from James. Final seconds of the quarter. Down to three. Two. Lewis.
Well, Coach, a 14-point deficit just as in game one Wednesday night, but what concerns you particularly this evening?
Well, we're not doing anything defensively. Our ball movement's terrible. We're turning it over. Everything's bad.
You only have 4 points in the paint after having 50 in game one.
Well, we've gotten the ball there. We've gotten the ball in the paint. We haven't been able to finish, and we've missed 5 free throws already.
All right, thanks a lot, thank you, Marv.
Marv, what I really see is the activity level defensively of Cleveland. You look at the numbers, they had 12 points off turnovers in the entire game one. Tonight they already have 9. So they're getting in the open court and running. But I think where I see this game is different tonight too, it's a different Cleveland team. They're throwing the ball in the post to Zdrinas Ogalskis. They've taken fouls against Dwight Howard. He's 2 of 6 from the foul line. Pavlovich has come in and hit a 3. So I think if you're Mike Brown, you look at that 14-point lead, but it looks different than it did the other night.
No question. Now LeBron James will get a rest here at the start of the second quarter. Turkoglu is back. Johnson fires a 3. And it carries out of bounds. So the Cavaliers now have Mo Williams back on the floor with Delonte West. And up front, Joe Smith, Ben Wallace, and Sasha Pavlovich as the second quarter gets underway. Cavaliers have their biggest lead of the night. Tony Battee has come on for Orlando. So they go with both Battee and Howard. Shot clock down to 5. Smith is fouled by Howard. And for Dwight, that is his first.
Now, with this second unit, Mike Brown uses Delonte West and Mo Williams as their scorers. So he said, you know, sometimes when you look at our bench, you look at the numbers and you look at scoring. It's not so much the scoring as the production. And the other night in the game, Ben Wallace, plus minus, was minus 14 when he was on the floor. Joe Smith, minus 8. Wally Szczerbiak, who we've not seen tonight, was minus 7. So they get outscored 25-5. But when they were on the floor, they had very negative numbers. That can't happen when they come in the game now. And Delonte West and Williams have to score.
And you see game one. Production from the Cavalier bench.
And Joe Smith's 5 points were all in the first half. So in that second half, LeBron James had 23 points. The rest of the team, 20. The bench had none.
Cavaliers have doubled up the score. Turgulu gets it down low. There's Petras over Pavlovich.
He's playing with such great confidence right now. I mean, you'd have to consider him really a starter. The guy's coming off the bench, but he actually was signed as a free agent to start. He had all kinds of injury problems this year, and he's found really a nice role as a sixth man with Courtney Lee starting.
Yeah, he's back after missing 28 games, sidelined by a fractured right wrist. Took him a while to get readjusted. Williams, rebounded by Howard. Good play by Ben Wallace, able to knock it away. Ben very quiet in a short stint. The other night played just 10 minutes, and as touched on earlier, talking with Cleveland head coach Mike Brown. Oh, look out, look out. As Mo Williams ends up to our right in the first row of the crowd.
This ball deflected, and he and Anthony Johnson get caught up. Ball is deflected. Both these guys coming right to you and I, Marv, and I'm trying to protect you right there.
You
I'm keeping Mo Williams away from you. I'm taking the hit.
You know what's sad? I did not even make a move.
I noticed that, but I'm trying to protect my man. That's all.
I had confidence. Turgulu not able to hit. And here's West. Tried that walk-up three and came up with the air ball.
See, that's a bad shot. When you're, again, Mark, when you're struggling and you're not shooting well, make sure you get good shots. Don't take high degree of difficulty shots. Pretty soon you've missed three or four in a row, and you're right back in that rut again.
There's Turgulu, still looking for his first bucket. And a good foul by Pavlovich, able to wrap up Howard, and that'll put him back at the line where he is just 2 of 6.
Now this is exactly what Mike Brown said. We got to wrap him up, especially guys coming off the bench. Ben Wallace, Joe Smith, Pavlovich, these guys have to use their fouls, make him go to the line. This will be his 7th and 8th free throws of the night.
As we watch Dwight Howard at the line, of programming reminder, TBS Wednesdays, Brown is back. Get the family together for the new season premiere of Tyler Perry's Meet the Browns, right after brand new episodes of House of Pain, May 27th at 10 o'clock Eastern Time, only on TBS. Dwight Howard the other night, 14 of 20 from the field. He had 30 points, 13 rebounds, one damage, 24 in second clock, and he did foul out.
Well, going into tonight's game, Dwight Howard had 100 field goals made in the playoffs, and 45 of them were dunks. And that's why you've got to foul him and make him go to the line. Use your fouls wisely.
Here's Williams on a curl, getting inside. He's blocked, but he's fouled. Strong move by Mo Williams, trying to take it to the rim. And the foul is on Petras. That's his second. Mo Williams, as we mentioned earlier, has not shot the ball well. Only 6 of 19 in game one against Orlando. You see game 3 and 4 in Atlanta. This is a guy who has emerged as an all-star since coming over in a major deal with the Milwaukee Bucks.
You know, Mark, when you look at that Atlanta series, you had LeBron, who played great. Delonte West played well. And Cleveland's defense was terrific. Other than that, their other offensive guys did not play. They were not in the sink. They got nothing off their bench. In the two games, 3 and 4 on the road, 7 and 8 points off their bench. Then 5 in game one. So offensively, they were out of sync. Defensively, they played well. And so now they're adjusting to another team. And this is a whole different challenge playing against the Magic.
J.J. Redick, three-year man out of Duke, who did not play at all, and in game one of the series has come on. West called for that foul as his first. J.J. did start throughout the series against the Celtics with Courtney Lee sidelined by injury. He's hitting a shot. Game six of the opening round series against Philadelphia, hit five threes and had it going first couple of games against Boston, and then struggled with the shot, but did a nice job at the defensive end, particularly against Ray Allen. Here's the shot clock down to two, and Redick has to shoot. Rebounded by Smith.
I see J.J. can play now because he can play Pavlovich. They did not like the matchups before with him having to guard either Mo Williams or Delonte West, two guys who are actually point guards.
There's Williams with a runner and got the roll. Williams with 9 points. And Ben Wallace hit the stanchion back behind the basket and took the, apparently in a collision. He was looking to get the foul call the other way, but Wallace picks up his first. Well, he's in a battle with Dwight Howard, and foul is on Wallace.
You know what I got a sense tonight, though? Cleveland's big men, Dwight Howard is feeling them tonight. The other night, he had his way. And Marv, tonight, they're contesting, they're fouling. It's just not the easy step, lay it up or dump the ball as it was the other night.
Ray for Alston is back. Coming on for Anthony Johnson. That's an offensive foul on Redick. As Mo comes out of the backcourt, Cavaliers in possession. They're up by 16. Looking to even this series at one. Here's Pavlovich to the rim. That's his second field goal. Opened up with a three when he first came on.
He's a very talented player, Marv. Again, and the big thing with him is just concentration and playing at a high level all the time. His talent, sometimes he floats.
He's out of Serbia, member of the Serbia Montenegro 2004 Olympic team. And in Athens, foul is called on Joe Smith. That is his second.
Fourth team foul.
There's the move by Sasha. Cavaliers committing their fourth team foul.
And you just look at the way Orlando scoring tonight, Mark. 50 points in the paint in game one. Tonight, only four. So Cleveland has done a great job of swarming, taking fouls. It's going to be an offensive foul on Dwight Howard. So a little of that Ben Wallace, the four-time defensive player of the year, the guy who was the backbone of those that championship team in Detroit, gets inside here using his quickness. You see Dwight Howard using that off-arm, that swim move, knocks back a Ben Wallace. So I would say Ben Wallace much more productive tonight in his stint on the floor than he was in game one.
Second on Howard, and it's been a tough year for Ben, back from that broken left foot, also a strained left knee. So he has been sidelined for a good portion of the season, but he has been a factor in this first half.
And what you want to be able to do is you know, they had Zydrunas Ilgauskas starting the game, and actually they went to him as an offensive player. They double-teamed Dwight Howard when Ilgauskas was in the game, and now that Ben Wallace is out there, they're singling him up a little bit, so they're changing their defenses based upon the personnel.
Now Howard sits down, and Marcin Gortat, who has played well throughout the playoffs, has to come on. Pavlovich with a beautiful move! Sasha Pavlovich! Once again to the rim, he has 7 points in 7 minutes of play.
And that's 9 bench points for Cleveland. That's found money after a game of only 5.
A 20-point Cavalier lead. A double up on Lewis. Redick pops it out to Turkoglu for 3. Rebounded by Smith, and Hedo's now 0 for 5 from the field.
Rashard Lewis 0 of 3, so those guys have no points. 0 for 8 tonight.
Williams guarded by Redick. Smith with room. Yes, that's a three for Joe Smith. The Cavaliers just under 60% of the field. And Stan Van Gundy wants to talk it over.
Our defense has got to carry us so we can fight back. And then down here, we've got to try to get some ball movement.
Well, this is what Stan Van Gundy's talking about. You look at game one, they had 32 assists and only 13 turnovers, moving the ball, getting shot. Tonight, look, three assists, six turnovers. That six turnovers have given Cleveland 13 points. So they're getting in the open court. And Marv, how about this? The other night, 77 points from behind the three-point line and in the paint combined for Cleveland, excuse me, for Orlando. Tonight they have seven. So they have locked down on the three-point shooters. They have defended the paint, and that's why they're up 23 right now.
And the Magic just 7 of 25 from the field, 5 of 10 at the line. With Dwight Howard struggling, just to 4 of 8. That's 3 on Smith.
It's third personal.
And the Cavs are now over the foul of it.
LeBron coming back into the game, and the positive sign for Mike Brown, you rested him. More importantly, you got a 9-point lead with him sitting on the bench, so you were +9 with him resting. The other night when he was out of the game, they were -7. A lot of the fatigue was that Mike Brown had to get him back into the game before he wanted to.
And number 23,
you see on the bench, actually 22 minutes of real time. So he gets a nice long rest over there, and his team performs with him sitting down. So that's when you use the quarter timeouts, you know, the timeout through the 8-9 minute mark or whatever. And so in essence, you end up missing about 5 minutes of action. You get like a 22 minute rest.
Lewis hits 1 of 2. Turkoglu, and that is his first field goal. He missed his previous 5. It's a 43-23 Cavalier lead. Bo Williams now played by Rafer Alston. Here's Williams for 3. And the ball hits the shot clock out of bounds.
He's drifting on his shot. Marvy was right there at the angle. I could see him. He's drifting left on his shot, and he missed left. He's got to go up straight. That's a lot of times what happens. A shooter will get into a little bit of a rut, and he's got to just take a look at that, get himself square, and get himself to the basket. His percentage will go up.
Turkoglu going at Varejão. Varejão did alter that shot. It's last touch by the Magic. And they're upset. They say no. Should be last touch by Cleveland. And the officials will talk it over. Tom Washington, Bill Kennedy come together, and they will change the call.
Well, Hedo Turkoglu trying to get himself involved in the game. He just hit a little baseline jumper. Very tough floater. Tough for us to see from that angle, but the ball will be with the Magic.
And now here's Zdrunas Ilgauskas back on the floor, coming out for Ben Wallace. Varejão went down. Cavs looking for a foul there. Lewis for 3. Rashard Lewis with his first field goal, coming off a terrific game 1. 9 of 13, 22 points, putting the game winner with just 14 seconds remaining. Orlando with 6 unanswered. Ilgauskas is pushed. Upset that he is not in position for a 3-point play off the foul by Rashard Lewis. Ilgauskas will go to the line. He'll shoot 2.
So when LeBron catches that ball on the wing and Orlando goes into that zone defense, that's when then Cleveland goes into their zone offense, and Varejão, Stan Van Gundy said he's the best cutting big man in the NBA. That time it was Ilgauskas cuts behind him, and he's the one who gets the ball and gets fouled and gets to the free throw line. So those guys do not stand. When they see that zone, they cut, and LeBron is a great passer.
And the Cavs 11 of 13 at the line. A reminder, Sunday, MLB on TBS brings you an interleague matchup between the Mets and the Red Sox. Cover starting 1:30 Eastern Time on TBS. Just under 6 minutes to play in this first half at the Q in Cleveland. It's an all Cavaliers. Reddick for 3. So J.J. Reddick, who went through that shooting slump after a couple of good games early on against the Celtics, did not play at all in game 1 of this series, and just knocks down a 3 to bring Orlando within 16. Gortat plays Ilgauskas very well, and that's a travel.
Gortat's a big strong guy, and Ilgauskas got caught changing pivot feet, but this is where Cleveland now doesn't want to have a letdown. We've seen how quickly Orlando can strike. If they could get this to 10 at halftime, they would have to feel very good about how poorly they played. They'd still be in the game.
Here's Redick, popping it to the corner. Alston fires for three, and it's rebounded by Ilgauskas. And as we discussed the other night, Orlando, a team of spurts that can go either way depending on how the three-point shot is falling. Cleveland is led by as many as 23. Ilgauskas, Gortat rebound. Varejão hits the deck, and the foul is called on the Cavaliers.
Now Varejão, he loves to act. The other night, Beatrice hit him, and we thought they were going to have to carry him off in a stretcher. So he draws a lot of contact this time. It looks like he got wrestled up. He had his arm inside Rashard Lewis and then made it look like Lewis was going to pull him down. Watch this as he comes. Both of them arm wrestling, and it looked like Varejão had him down, went, pulled him down with that shoulder. So you don't want to put a guy, Rashard Lewis, who's struggling right now, 1-of-4 from the floor, put him on and let him make a couple free throws, Marv. That's the one thing. Make him make jump shots.
Varejão with his third, as you saw. He's replaced by Ben Wallace, and Rashard Lewis having some difficulties at the line. Well, we've seen several big comeback wins in the 2009 playoffs. Philadelphia at Orlando, down by as many as 18. Orlando did it for the Cavaliers here in game one. The Hornets came back from 16 against Denver.
They weren't able to bounce back from that 58-point loss when they got the next game.
Ilgauskas set up by James and tips it home.
Cleveland's really doing a good job of moving the ball, spacing the floor. Ball's moving, players are moving. That ball is not sticking. That's why they're getting such high percentage shots.
Alston with the step, met by Ilgauskas and foul. Ray for Alston, headed to the line. And for Ilgauskas, his first personal. Orlando just 7 of 14 at the line. Alston a 75% free throw shooter during the regular season after Jahnir Nelson was injured. He was acquired from the Rockets in that three-team deal. He was in his fourth year with Houston and playing well. He had spent time with Stan Van Gundy when Stan was head coach of the Miami Heat. Rafer, a New York City schoolyard legend known for his skip to my Lou moves, not necessarily in the NBA, but in the playground.
Plus also he played for Jeff Van Gundy in Houston, so he got a good scouting report from his brother as well. So I think he had a pretty good handle on who Alston was.
Ilgauskas rejected by Gortat. Does Jeff charge for those scouting reports?
Jeff charges for everything.
And the ball back to the Cavaliers. 4 minutes to play in this first half. Marv Albert, Doug Collins, Craig Sager for Quicken Loans Arena in Cleveland. Game two of this Eastern Conference Final Series. Cavaliers trying to even things up. Orlando looking to go up 2-0. Turkoglu off the steal, chased down, oh, he's blocked, he's hit hard by West. And Turkoglu shake it up. The officials discussing it. The possibility of a flagrant foul here.
It was interesting. If you watch LeBron James on this play, he's coming in from behind. He's trying to size up the block. Now watch LeBron turn this ball over. Turkoglu's going to get in the open court. Here's Delonte West running him down. He's going to take the hard foul. And here's LeBron. He's getting ready for one of those blocks from behind. So
not a flagrant foul, personal foul on Delonte West. That is being explained to Stan Van Gundy, who questioned Tom Washington. They are still involved in that discussion.
So you get 4 points in the paint. You're 3 of 10 from three, and you've missed 8 free throws. One of the reasons why you're down 15.
And the Magic, not a good free throw shooting team, but it's primarily because of Dwight Howard. The rest of the guys are usually solid at the line.
That's why it was always sort of a skewed stat. Whichever team Shaq was on usually was 30th in the league. But, you know, a lot of times you have three or four of the really good free throw shooters on your team, but each shoot 10 or 11 a game.
Williams passed on a three. Fighting James. LeBron has 10 points. Here's Redick. As Orlando got the ball down court in a hurry, and the Cavaliers did not react.
I like what Cleveland's doing, making the extra pass. We haven't seen LeBron at the top of the floor tonight with a ball. You know, we're seeing a lot of dribble handoffs. They're running some weaves, getting some movement, getting a little screens on the move, spreading them out.
Mo Williams runs out, rebounded by Dwight Howard, and makes his return. There was not the kind of staging of the NBA draft that we have become accustomed to.
I got a phone call. That was what it was.
Oh, they swarm all around Rashawn Lewis, and a foul was called. So once again, Lewis to the line, the foul on Williams. We've been talking about the up and down play by the Orlando Magic, and this has been their pattern. We saw it against the Sixers, saw it against the Celtics, and in game one down by 16 and came from behind.
You know what I compare it to a little bit, Marv? You're an old boxing guy. You know, a guy who has a knockout punch, he can be, you know, getting beat throughout the fight. He's got that knockout punch and he can win. They have a shooting chance. They're the kind of team that can get hot in 4 or 5 minutes, hit 4, 5, 6 threes, and be right back in the game. So they have, anytime you can score, you've always got a chance.
And with the three-pointer during the regular season, they shot 38%, which was among the leaders, but they were second in the NBA in total three-pointers made and attempts, setting franchise records in both categories, although tonight, just 3 of 10 from downtown. James with the spin. LeBron James taking it to the rim. We have not seen the stoppages in the Cleveland flow in their offense with LeBron, who had just an incredible night in game one with the 49 points. Lewis able to knock down a three. But LeBron, by holding the ball constantly at the elbow, was actually stopping the offense. Obviously you're happy with 49 points, but other players were not able to get involved.
And I think because he had it going so well, the guy said, just go with it. And then, you know, he got tired at the end of the game. Right now he's very fresh. Look at his shot. Nothing but power. The streak to go into the defensive player of the year, Dwight Howard, take the contact and get the finish. 7 shots tonight for LeBron James. He's hit 5, 14 points. Very efficient game.
J.J. Redick right back. The difference tonight for LeBron is he is attacking the rim. But the Magic have come back from a 23-point deficit. It is now a 53-42 Cleveland lead as we approach a minute remaining in this first half. Williams with the runner. And he tried to steal it from Howard, not able to control, so the ball back to the Magic.
LeBron James, just, he looks like J.J. Redick wants to take a charge. He just rolls off of him and just powers through Dwight Howard. Look at this powerful finish. And this time, how many guys have the ability to have this kind of upper body strength to take that hit and finish and get the score? Why don't we talk about it again? It's an 11-point game right now. The Orlando Magic were down 15 at the half the other night. So, again, if they can get this in single digits, you know, psychologically going in at half, as Stan Van Gundy told me the other night, they were being witnesses to LeBron James. They took it personally and came out and played in the third quarter.
Stan had some great lines the other night as we were able to listen in on the huddle. Alston is off the mark, rebounded by Turgaloo. Nice pass. And it's rebounded by Ilgauskas. 53-42. Cavaliers, half minute left, first half. Here's James again to the rim, fouled by Gortat. So LeBron James will shoot two. He is 4 for 4 at the line. Coming up, the T-Mobile halftime report. Ernie Charles Kenny and Reggie will have analysis of the first half. Ernie pretending that he is doing work as he...
He's talking to Ryan McIntyre up there in the league office, probably trying to get some scuttlebutt what's going on in the NBA.
Checking if your Cavaliers are 8 times Kinsey and number one.
Earlier he was talking to one of the ushers out there.
Speaking of Usher, I see Usher here tonight. It was funny. Marv, you and I were talking before the game. I said, I haven't seen Usher in a while. And look up, and right across the floor from us is Usher. So,
also
big game
Cavaliers
here tonight with him
number
being
four,
here.
Big Ben
and, has a minority ownership in the Cleveland Cavaliers. LeBron James with the last 8 points for the Cavs. 13-point lead, down to 25 seconds remaining in the half. 7-second differential between the game clock and shot clock. Here's Turkoglu.
Wow.
And Wallace got a piece of that.
What a tough shot. See what the Pavlovich in the game was guarding Turkoglu that time, so they were able to take off LeBron to get him to rest a little bit with the lead and let him guard Rashard Lewis. So you're already seeing tonight some different matchups. And what Mike Brown told us before the game is that I've got to be able to pick and choose during the game exactly who can guard who at certain times so that come fourth quarter, I know what I want to do with the matchups.
17 seconds to play in this first half. Cavaliers have led by as many as 23. They're shooting 53% for the half, led by LeBron, who has 16. Zydrunas Ilgauskas with 10 points. Rashard Lewis coming out of the second quarter. He's a high man for Orlando with all 10 of his points in this second quarter, but the Magic at just 39%. James running that clock down. Down to three, down to two. On the spin, here's LeBron, and he'll go to the line. Took a shot to the head. 1.4 remaining in this first half. Petras collecting his third, and James will shoot two.
See, that's their money play. What they like to do is they like to run a screen roll. This time they get JJ Redick switched off onto LeBron James. He goes inside and gets fouled. See, Petras is guarding him, so they run that little screen roll, little 3-1 or 3-2 pick and roll based upon whether the point guard or the two guard is setting it. And then if LeBron gets the mismatch, that's where he goes to work. What happened the other night, Marv, in the second half, he got caught up at the top. They ran that a lot. That's when he started over-dribbling. So tonight they have not used that as much. They've got a lot more movement in their offense. A lot of guys are involved. But there's 26 points in the paint tonight, getting the ball inside. Only 8 for the Magic after having 50 in game one. So that's the huge difference in this ball game tonight.
LeBron hits one of two. He has 17 points. Second and a half left in this first half. Oh, the steal! And Pavlovich thought that he was fouled, but will not get the call.
The score at the half.
And you hear the reaction from this crowd. But the Cavaliers up by 12 at halftime. Orlando ended the half on a 24-13 run.
I think the positive of this is the activity level of Sasha Pavlovich. He's been in this game. He's been a factor in a positive way. And with the Orlando Magic playing such a small lineup in many instances, they're going to need this guy as this series goes on.
Well, LeBron James leads the way, 17 points, 5 of 7 from the field, 7 of 8 at the line. And LeBron has been taking it to the rim right from the start. And he is alongside Craig Sager.
Well, LeBron, you had the last 9 points, but you got quite a lift from Sasha Pavlovich. You hinted yesterday at practice you'd like to see him play. Doug Collins mentioned that you had him next to your locker before the game. How did you mentally get him ready?
I told him to just be ready to play, man. We was in the locker room before, getting taped and everything. I told Sasha, be ready, because I think it's a time for you to, you're going to get some good minutes, and he definitely played well.
A lot of adjustments. I saw you 3 hours before the game with your routine. You also had a lot of bottles of fluids. Keep hydrated. How do you feel, and what will you do at halftime?
I feel great. You know, halftime, we gotta, for me as an individual, just stay a little bit hydrated, get some liquids in me. But we're gonna come up with another game plan and try to finish the game out.
It's too hard for us right now. Like, we want to just get the rebound, and we're not ready. They're coming. We don't have anybody who wants to stop the ball. How are you going to to win if they're going to play harder and tougher. Come on now. Get back. Shrink the floor and close.
Well, the other night, the Magic came back from a 16-point deficit. Doug, they're down by as many as 23. They did make a move in the second quarter, though, as we just saw Stan Van Gundy was very upset.
Well, you know, he gave him a little bit of a motivation in game one. We'll see how they respond. This first 5 minutes of the third quarter is going to be very important, Marv. But I think that to be where they are right now, they're very lucky after how poorly they played. And the one thing that Cleveland has done is they've shored up, Marv, that storyline I talked about. These three problem areas, they were plus 16. Cleveland was minus 16 in game one. In the regular season in three games, they were minus 30 in these three areas. Tonight, they are plus 16. So the difference here is they have done a great job in the paint. That's the difference in the ball game right now. Actually, plus 18 in those areas. So they've done a good job. But this first 5 minutes of the third quarter, remember now the other night, Orlando came out with a 7-0 run and got right back in the ball game.
Orlando ended the half on a 24-13 spurt. They double up on Howard. Recovered by Lee. Shot clock down to four. Down to two. Can Lewis get it off? He does. Rebounded by James.
Yeah, great possession by Cleveland. Double teamed the post, scrambled out. Got to the shooter, forced him to take it off the three-point line and shoot a tough two that was contested. Good possession.
Yogauskas had a good first half. James led the way with 17. James for Ilgauskas, and it's broken up. He was stripped. Good look, though, by LeBron with Dwight Howard coming out on a switch to meet him. Let's check in with Craig.
Well, Wednesday night, we briefly mentioned the father-son matchup and assistant coaches. That's Brendan Malone over on the Orlando bench and his son, Michael Malone, over on the Cleveland bench. Now, I talked a few moments ago to the mother and the husband, I mean the wife, Maureen. Oh, nice three by LeBron James. She's back watching the game in her home in New York, and I said, where do your loyalties lie? She goes, tell Doug Collins, I love my kids, but I've been married to Brendan for 46 years. I say go Blue. I'm wearing my Magic t-shirt and my Magic pants.
Well, that certainly clears it up. LeBron James extending to a 14-point lead. It's another Orlando turnover. James off the pick. Rebounded by Howard. Dwight Howard with 12 rebounds. Turkoglu hit on a reach-in by Delonte West. A very quiet first half for Dino Turkoglu. Just 2 of 8.
His third personal.
5 points. Dwight Howard just 2 of 6 from the field. 8 points.
Mark, those three guys have combined for 23 points. The other night they had 67. On top of that, Turkoglu had 14 assists.
And a foul on West is third. Here's Alston with a running hook. Back comes West. And Orlando able to get back. Williams played by Alston. LeBron is open.
Yes.
So we're seeing LeBron James hit the perimeter shot. He has scored the last 13 points for the Cavaliers.
But he's playing off the ball. A lot of his is movement away, getting the screen, catching and shooting, rather than have to beat guys off the dribble. It makes the game so much easier for him.
Lewis with a step back, but the jab step that is so effective for Rashard Lewis.
Especially when you got Barajal, bigger player, not normally playing a guy on the perimeter, but he's actually done a nice job in the half court against Lewis. Where he's been hurt is in the open court for the threes.
Well, Williams not able to hit on that three-point attempt. Nice pass inside by Lee as Howard was able to work himself deep. To 46, the Cavaliers trying to even up this series at one apiece. Game three in Orlando. Barajal, the tip missed by Ilgauskas. Well, the Magic looking to come from behind to take a 2-0 lead in this best of seven. Turkoglu being played here by West. Pergolou.
Yes. Well, he's got the size advantage. When they posted him in the first half with Delonte West, Cleveland was double-teaming him. That time he takes it down on the baseline where he could use his superior height and just shoot over the smaller guard.
So the Cleveland lead is down to 12. Shot clock to 7. Barzal goes at Howard. Little flip shot. So Anderson Barzal with the reverse. And that is his first field goal. Turkin with a hard driving move, and Hino showing some signs here in the third quarter.
We see what happened. They did not help off Dwight Howard that time, as Zdrunas Ilgauskas stayed attached to him, and you had the defender going underneath that screen. He could not get back to the angle.
Here's Williams. Oh! Remember, in game one, Orlando has a big third quarter. They outscored the Cavaliers 30-19 lead. So Courtney Lee's jumper cuts it back to 12. Now James played by Turgulu. Backs it up. Ilgauskas set the screen. LeBron finds the wide open Mo Williams. Ilgauskas try to save it. And he was pushed.
That's the shot, though, that Mo Williams is going to have to start making, Marv. He was 44% from behind the three-point line in the regular season, 36% going into tonight. That spot-up three that he and Delonte West shot so well in the regular season, they with all the attention that LeBron James gets on drives, they've got to knock those jump shots down.
Well, apparently that was called knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Orlando. James not able to hit, and it's rebounded by Lewis. 5 minutes gone by in the third. And the foul underneath. It is on Ilgauskas. That is his second.
In the open court, Marv, what's happening is Dwight Howard is getting deep post position. He is just running to the front of the rim. And you can see the Cleveland is spread out. He's going and putting his head right underneath the basket. He got a score earlier, and this time a foul.
There's Lewis from straight away for three.
And now, Mark, it's a 9-point game. And to put that in perspective, when you play the Magic, that's three possessions. Three possessions.
Third three for Rashard Lewis. Ilgauskas rebounded by Turgulu. Lewis from downtown again.
This is amazing. The minute Cleveland gets careless on offense, it triggers the runouts.
Six minutes to play in the third. They get the ball out of LeBron's hands. Now James, played by Turgulu, able to split through. That will count on the foul. He is so good at getting off the shot as he is fouled. Lewis picks up the foul as second.
Well, you got quickness, you got strength, you got power, and you got balance. I mean, you got all these things, and then you got the wherewithal and the concentration to get greedy and go for the three-point shot. That's the one thing. Great players hear that whistle, and they're thinking three, not just two.
However, LeBron not able to complete the three-point play. 66-58, Cavaliers. They've led by as many as 23, led by 12 at the half. The Magic in the midst of a major comeback once again. That time, Lewis way off on a three-point attempt. James met by Lewis. Here's James. Finding West in the corner. Barzal faking the shot and now gets in close to back it home.
I think the crowd made that happen. He started to shoot twice and then was like, no. And so he did his little dribble and banked one in off the backboard.
Anderson not noted for the outside touch. Here's Lee for three.
Now that's typical basketball of Orlando. Middle pick and roll, roll Dwight Howard. The corner man has to step up and help on the roll, and you kick out to his man for the three. That's an inside-out play that works so well for them off the screen roll.
James again to the bucket. He's turned back, able to recover, scores, and a foul. And we just saw a prime example of the power and the strength of LeBron James.
And just staying with this, the first time he thought he got hit on the play, no call, and then he comes right back. So another opportunity for a three-point play the hard way. And this guy is very accustomed to doing this during the course of the season.
And now able to complete the three-point play. That foul of Dwight Howard. He has three. But once again here tonight, Doug, we're seeing the mental toughness of the Orlando Magic. They take that seven-game series with the Celtics by winning a game seven in Boston. Alston not able to hit a three. Here comes Williams. Mo Williams lost the dribble.
That's a great play by Rafer Alston, running him down from behind.
Turned over the alley-oop, fielded by Howard, and blocked by Ilgauskas. Howard is looking for a foul. Timeout called by the Cavaliers.
20-second timeout.
A 10-point lead for the Cavaliers with 4 minutes, 19 seconds to go in this third quarter. How about LeBron James? 18 points the last 11 minutes, 26 in all for the night.
I like it, though. Look at this, Mark. 14 shot attempts. So he's 9 of 14. The other night, he was 20 of 30. So there's better distributions in the shots, and he's been to the line 10 times. So 26 points on 14 shots. You see him really taking a lot of the liquids. You know, Mark, when I played, I sweat a lot. But I couldn't drink that much because I felt like if it got in my stomach, it was sloshing around. I mean, he's drinking so much fluid as this game is going on just to prevent himself from cramping up. But again, I didn't have those kind of muscles either.
Really? So I did not realize
you
that.
You didn't realize I was not that heavily muscled?
Sometimes finesse is good. Orlando getting back into it after trailing by as many as 23. Cleveland has it back up to 10. Here's Williams with the runner. And rebounded by Howard. Number 17 off the glass for Howard. Lee is open for three.
Well, Cleveland been very fortunate because Orlando's missed 2 points. Point-blank threes from the corner in the last two possessions.
There's James. Met by Lewis. Control. Last touch by the Magic.
And see LeBron picking at that left leg there. That's the leg that he fell on the other night and was bleeding on that last play when he dove to force the jump ball that he tipped back to Mo Williams 1 second to go. The shot did not go. So if there's any kind of blood there, then the trainer obviously will have to tend to that.
Eight on the shot clock for the Cavaliers. West will throw it in. James's pass broken up. And Courtney Lee, as he crossed midcourt line.
Baseball foul on Orlando's number 15, Keto Turkoglu.
Apparently the foul on Turkoglu. It's a loose ball foul on Turkoglu. And for Hedo, his third.
Let's take a look at this. This ball is loose. Let's see if he gets caught holding LeBron. They said he held LeBron right there. That would have been an easy two for Courtney Lee. Obviously, Stan Van Gundy not happy with that call. That would have been an easy two that would have cut the lead back down to 8.
And now Cavaliers athletic trainer Max Benton, who has been very busy these first two games, is taking care of the blood on the left leg of LeBron James. For more on this, let's go to Craig Sager.
Well, athletic trainer Max Benton is attending to LeBron James. They want to put a Band-Aid across his leg, and LeBron said no, just stop the bleeding. I also talked to Max at halftime. He said that LeBron, to replenish the fluids that Doug was talking about, how profusely he sweats, he had 3 20-ounce bottles of liquid at intermission. So Right now, as you mentioned, athletic trainer Max Benton is very busy. And also our buddy Ernie Talisman, who got injured sitting over you next to you, Doug. He is back, as we promised. He got attended to by Max Benton. He got his legs all taped up. And the number one season ticket holder from 36 years is back to see the second half.
Mark? Max has covered a lot of ground here tonight.
Don't you notice in the playoffs how much busier these athletic trainers get? I mean, these guys do such incredible work throughout the year. The amount of hours they work tending to the athletes, especially on the road, and all they have to do. And then come playoff time, guys are on the floor, guys getting nicked, cut. We've seen it all throughout the playoffs. And they're going to make LeBron come back again because they said they can still see the blood. So it might be that athletic trainer Max Benton might have to put a wrap on that. LeBron obviously does not want anything on that leg, so Sasha Pavlovich will come in and LeBron will be tended to.
LeBron's on the go, checking in number three, Sasha Pavlovich.
Sasha Pavlovich played very well in the first half, did not play at all in game one, 13 minutes, 3 of 4 from the field, 7 points. After seeing very little time in the earlier playoff series against Detroit and Atlanta, after turnover, here come the Magic. Lewis gives it out to Kurgelew. Kurgelew down low. Nice pass to Lewis. Cannot finish. Rebounded by Ogalskis.
Yeah, good job by Ogalskis there. Just come over and to bother that shot enough to where Rashard Lewis had to try to use the backboard and missed an easy one.
Williams on the move, and he is fouled. He's hit by Alston. Team foul number 4. On Orlando, that's 3 on Alston, and now LeBron James is back.
See, the importance of the last 3 minutes here, if you're Cleveland. Remember the other night, Orlando made the push, got it to 4. LeBron rested, and before he could get back in the game, Orlando had taken the lead. So finishing quarters here, very important. They'd love to have a lead so LeBron can get some rest.
LeBron with that wrap on his left foot. Here's James on the move, and he scores. 28 for LeBron James. Cleveland back up by 12. Lewis passed out of 3 and hits the 2. He thought he was fouled.
You see, it's such a tough cover because Varejão wants to run back to the paint. His normal reaction is to help in the lane. And when you're playing Rashard Lewis, you've got to meet him at the 3-point line. He just stepped right into that shot.
Here's the lead pass for West, and he is fouled. LeBron James connecting with Dante West, who was fouled by Dwight Howard. That's number 4 on Howard. Delonte West at the line. Delonte, 83% free throw shooter. He's had a good postseason. Did not shoot well in game one. Played very well against Atlanta, particularly game 4. 21 points, tying his postseason career high. Made big plays in the fourth quarter. He's had a solid season for the Cavs. Foul is on Smith in the act. Question is, was he 3-point territory? It is 4 on Smith, and it appears that was a 3-point attempt.
Absolutely, he reaches his hand in there, and that's a bad play by Joe Smith. You do not want to foul a 3-point shooter. If anything, you try to get a hand up and put it in his face. We saw Carmelo Anthony do that last night to Kobe, get a hand up. You've seen Shane Battier just get a hand in the face. And these great players will still knock shots down, but you don't want to foul a 3-point jump shooter.
And they are reviewing as to whether it was a 3-point attempt.
Well, he's clearly behind the 3-point line. Now, remember the other night he pump faked Anderson Varejão in the air. He actually started out, Marv, behind the 3-point line, but by the time he released it, he had stepped in. They reviewed it, and it was only 2.
Monty McCutcheon, the crew chief, taking a look at the videotape review, and now indicates, yes, it is a 3-point attempt. So Rashard Lewis, 4 of 6 at the line, will have 3 free throws. He has 18 points after going scoreless, Doug, in the first quarter, and he's 4 of 5 from downtown.
Well, remember now, the other night, he made his last 7 shots. He missed his first shot to start the third quarter, about the 11:38 mark, hit his last 7. More importantly, all 5 in the fourth quarter, and had 12 fourth quarter points. So this is a guy that can get hot. And when you bring Turkoglu back into the game with him that's out there now, and they start running those pick and rolls, that's going to be a challenge for Cleveland in the fourth period.
See the breakdown in game one as he hit all 5 of his shots in the fourth quarter. Had that big game against Cleveland in early April with Orlando defeating Cleveland by 29. And Rashard, 22 points, 5 three-pointers. You go back to regular season play, where the Magic took 2 of 3 against the Cavaliers. They have won 9 of their last 12 games against Cleveland. James could not save it. So the ball back to Orlando. And the Magic with 4 wins the last 6 games here.
Checking if you're Cavaliers.
And believe me, Marv, I want to tell you something. When you walk in a building as a player and as a coach, and you've won 4 of the last 6 there, you've just won in there in a playoff game, you have a lot of confidence walking in that locker room. The only time that the Orlando Magic has lost this year to Cleveland, Rashard Lewis was 0-for-8 from the 3-point line. So that's the only time they were able to beat them, when they shut him down from behind the line.
Foul on the Cavaliers, number 32, Joe Smith.
And the foul is on Smith. That is number 5. That call away from the ball. Next foul puts Cleveland over.
Checking back in, replacing Joe, is number 2.
You see what's happened now. LeBron James has gone over to Rashard Lewis. He's going to try to cool him off. And that's what Mike Brown has done. He's put him on some different guys, but he's going over to Rashard Lewis now to try to cool him down. And now they have Pavlovich on Turkoglu.
Here's Turkoglu for 3.
Turkoglu.
The 8th three-pointer for the Magic after the slow start. They're now 8 of 19, and the Magic right back into it. They are within 6 after trailing by 23.
Well, who was it? Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid said, who are these guys? And they just will not go away.
James, that time forced it. It's back tap, saved by Pavlovich. 1 on the shot clock. Williams comes up short. Gortat with the rebound as we come up on a minute to play in this third quarter. Once again, the Magic with a big third quarter. That the scenario in game 1 here on Wednesday night. Nice move by Turkoglu. Rebounded by Wallace. James on the move. The Magic getting back. West pulls it back.
How smart not to take that shot. Had he missed, there was nobody there to get a rebound.
Pavlovich for 3. For top rebound.
So they look for a quick 2-for-1 here, about a 15-second differential. It looks like now they're going to hold it.
Shot clock at 10. Lee with the runner. Courtney Lee will knock out. Offensive foul.
Well, Ben Wallace made a great play there. The question is, had Courtney Lee left the floor before Ben Wallace got to his spot? Look at this. Now, when he leaves the floor, now Ben Wallace is there. That is a good call. He's outside the restricted area. That's a big play. That would have cut the lead, but down to 4.
Courtney Lee with that Rip Hamilton look wearing the protective mask because of that fractured sinus cavity. Back in the starting lineup after sitting out several games. Here's James with the quarter coming to a close. And not a good one for the Cavaliers.
It's
the fourth quarter. This is the time right now.
Well, Coach, I don't have to tell you that 23-point lead's now down to 6. What do you want to see differently in the fourth quarter from your team from what happened Wednesday night?
You know, a couple of times on the pick and roll coverage, we didn't do the right thing. We didn't switch when we were supposed to switch, and it cost us. So we got to make sure that we know what we're doing out there in our pick and roll coverage.
What type of ball movement do you want from the offensive end?
You know, we got to drive the basketball. There was a stretch there when they cut into the lead, but we took 3 or 4 straight threes. And we can't just rely on the 3 ball tonight. We got to drive the ball and force the action.
All right, thanks a lot. Back to Marvin Dunn.
All right, guys. The Magic with a 25-19 advantage over the Cavaliers in the third quarter. They are within 6 points after trailing by as many as 23. Here's James, went to the left hand. Rebound is snatched by Lewis, looking for some help. Anthony Johnson is back on the floor, so Johnson and Lee in the backcourt. Will Todd playing for Howard with four fouls. Nice lead pass on a pick and roll. Johnson combining with Gortat, and it's a four-point game.
Hey, it's interesting. We've not seen Michael Pietrus at all. He's been playing so well off the bench. So Stan Van Gundy finding some things to work. To follow up what Mike Brown said, 0 for 7 from 3 for the Cleveland Cavaliers. They only took 6 the entire first half.
Here's Delonte West. 10 points for West. Similar to what took place in game one, the Magic shooting has picked up following a poor shooting first quarter. Turtle played by Wallace. James is on Lewis. James got picked off. Shot clock down at 2. Turtle fires. The long rebound is handled by Williams.
It's that small lineup now. LeBron is out there on the floor as a four-man. Pavlovich is a 3.
There's James on the drive. He is fouled. He was tripped up. So LeBron heads back to the line.
See what's happening now, Marv, defensively with Orlando. They can, a lot of these pick and rolls can be switched. But here's LeBron James. Once again, he gets the memo. Looks like he barrels right through Gortat. Going to go to the line to shoot two, but coming out of that timeout, Mike Brown said enough of the jump shots. You heard him talking to Craig Sager. The last possessions have been drive that ball to the rim.
Anthony Johnson picked up the personal. National coverage of the NBA playoffs continues tomorrow on ABC. Game 3 of the Lakers and the Nuggets starting 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Sunday here on TNT, Game 3. Cavs and Mavs starting 8 o'clock Eastern Time. And then Monday on ESPN, Game 4 between the Lakers and Nuggets as that Western Conference final series continues.
And Marv, with the Orlando cutting in that lead at the end of the third quarter, LeBron James starts the fourth, so no rest. Normally he gets a little bit of time to rest.
8-point lead for the Cavaliers. Johnson puts it up for Gortat, who had actually, it appeared he lost the grip on the ball.
I tell you, I like this guy. I talked about how well he played on a Western road trip. They went into Utah. He had a big game at Utah to help them win in a very tough building.
There's Pavlovich. He gets the call. Yes, and the foul. It's a blocking foul. Although Gortat thought it should have been a charge. So Sasha Pavlovich continues to play at a very high level, and he'll head to the line.
Now, once again, a very close play there. Two bang-bang plays in a row involving Gortat. He gets called now for a technical, so now adding insult to injury here. But again, coming out of that fourth quarter, you've seen Cleveland with one thing on their mind. Drive the ball to the basket. Stop shooting jump shots. It's what got them in trouble in game one. And especially if Dwight Howard is not in the game with no shot blocking, you have got to go to the basket.
Well, Williams knocks down the technical. And here's Pavlovich to the line. Sasha playing only 16 minutes a game during the regular season. And he struggled at the line, 25 for 54 for 46%. Unable to complete the three-point play, and it's deflected out by Wallace.
Well, Pavlovich has played 17 minutes tonight in the 7 playoff games previous. Out of the 9, he had 2 EMPs. He had only 38 total minutes, so he's getting his time tonight and coming in and performing well.
82-73. Cleveland in front. Pavlovich defending on Turgulu.
See, they can switch those screen rolls now. Now they got Pavlovich matched up on Lewis. So their money play that cost him so many baskets the other night, Marv, the Turgulu-Lewis screen roll. With Pavlovich and James out there together, they're just switching it. And so now they're taking Lewis. Remember how he was rolling out the other night and catching and shooting? Now they're switching it. And what he's going to try to do now is go in the post, but it's taking away that catch and shoot that was so effective the other night.
Dwight Howard returns, coming on for Marcin Gortat. Howard playing with the four fouls. Here's Turgulu to the rim. Strong move by Ido Turkoglu's been coming on in the second half. Now 14 points. 7 points. Cavalier lead 9.5 to play in the fourth. Shot clock down to 5. Here's James kicking it out. They swing it. Pavlovich for 3. And that came up short.
I do like the movement, though. I do like they moved, they drove, they kicked, they tried to get to the rim. Howard's back on the floor. You maybe challenge him, get his fifth foul.
Stan Van Gundy going with Anthony Johnson at the point. Johnson and Lee in the backcourt. Lewis, Howard, Turkoglu up front. And it's Pavlovich on Turkoglu. Now Wallace switches off. Here is Lee and the foul. Howard chasing that either shot or pass attempted by Lee. And a foul on Mo Williams. Timeout taken.
More of this call, a little step-up screen on the sideline. Rather than coming to the middle, it's going to come down the sideline. They're going to roll Gortat. And see, on the weak side, Mo Williams is playing a three-point shooter. So afraid to help. So you see all guys behind the three-point line. If you help, you kick out to the three-point shooters. That's on Gortat with a nice finish. And Dwight Howard has been on the bench for some fouls. He's back in the ballgame. Michael Pietrus is back in the game. He's only played 8 minutes tonight after playing almost 30 in game one.
Courtney Lee at the line. As it turns out, Courtney and LeBron James know each other very well. Lee served as a camp counselor in one of LeBron's basketball camps in Indianapolis while Courtney was at Western Kentucky.
I actually spoke at that camp. LeBron asked me to come in and speak to the campers, the top 100 players from Nike, and it's amazing how much time LeBron spends with those young players. Courtney Lee was a college counselor, and what happens, they play at night, and LeBron would play with the guys, and he's very engaged in his camps. It's just not his name. He very much is out there working with those young guys.
I know you took part in Color War that they had that particular day. All right, here's James getting to the rim, and a foul is called. It's an offensive foul. Monty McCutcheon took a long look and then made the call. It's against the Cavaliers. It's on LeBron James.
LeBron, that was almost like when he was playing football. He picks his ball up and he's like trying to run through the linebacker there. Hits him with the shoulder.
It is a 5-point game. Here's Turkoglu. Fires one up and he's called for the offensive foul.
That's what Bergeau's doing. Bergeau's not a shot blocker. So when you play Cleveland, you have to understand their big men are going to step up and take charges. They're not going to leave their feet. You see Bergeau there sliding nicely sideways. And as long as you're going in, you know, backwards, you could be moving a little side laterally as long as you're moving backwards. And that's what happened.
James comes up short. Bergeau not able to control. That foul on Turkoglu, his fourth. He picked up 3 early. He's been able to hang in despite that early foul trouble. He has been missed the fourth quarter, and he's showing signs here in the early moments of the fourth. For those who may have just joined us, Cleveland at 1 point led by as many as 23. They're up by 12 at the half. Shot clock to 3. Here is Lee. Bergeau able to get to the board.
That's a nice job, though. You force Courtney Lee to take that ball off the dribble and shoot a floater. There's going to be another offensive foul on LeBron James. That was an easy call there. He just ran right through Michael Pietrus.
So we've had 3 consecutive calls of offensive foul.
Yeah, this one, there was no question. He ran right through him that time. So it'll be interesting now as this game gets down here. LeBron James, it looks like he's going to play the entire second half, except maybe for those couple little times he went out to get his leg attended to. Remember how he cramped up in game one.
Third foul on James.
switching that screen roll. This time Howard tries to go into the post.
Here's Petrus with a rainbow three. So Michael Petrus has been sitting for quite some time. After picking up a third, we have not seen him. Comes back with a three. And the Cleveland lead is down to two. There's a little too much dribble, and it's deflected out. Last touch by Howard. Now the officials check with each other. It's Bill Kennedy and Tom Washington discussing that play.
Well, Varejao gets caught with a ball here, gets caught over handling it. They're going to say now that they've conferred it's going to be Orlando ball. You see the look on Dwight Howard's face. Marlon, I'm telling you right now, all the pressure is on the Cleveland Cavaliers right now. Orlando has put them under the gun. It's the game Cleveland said, we must win. You don't want to go down 0-2. Well, right now, they are under the gun.
Three straight turnovers committed by the Cavaliers. Here's Lee, and the game is tied at 82.
How fearless is this young guy? Boy, he is not running away from the shot. A beautiful little left-hand shot off the glass.
6 minutes, 40 seconds to go in the fourth. James to the rim. And the Cavaliers back up by two.
The one thing, though, Marv, this cannot just be the LeBron James show. His teammates have got to be prepared. He will pass the ball, and they're going to have to knock down some shots. There's that switch once again. If they go into post and double team, it could free up a three-point shot.
It's a mismatch. Lillard shooting over West.
That's a problem now because now they're switching that screen roll, and Delonte West is caught on him. It's no longer a Pavlovich or LeBron James. So now Mike Brown is going to have to make an adjustment.
Welcome back to an action, pressure-filled Eastern Conference Final from the Q in Cleveland. The score tied at 84. I talked to LeBron James yesterday at practice, and I said, how much pressure do you personally feel? He said, I try to play basketball. I try not to let it bother me. But he goes, it's there. You see it, you hear it, you feel it. He goes, it's not just me. It's also those 20,000 fans in the arena. And yes, you can feel it. They want to have a home court advantage, but I'm telling you, Marv, they feel as much pressure as those players on the court right now because they know what happened on Wednesday night.
And Craig, another impressive performance here by the Orlando Magic, and all this coming off the win in Game 7 in Boston, and they had come back in that series after trailing 3-2 against a shorthanded Celtic team. They win Game 1 here after trailing by as many as 16. They were down in this game 43-20, a 23-point deficit. Cleveland has led all the way, and here we are, 6 minutes, 8 seconds to go in the fourth. And the game is tied at 84.
That's what happens when you can shoot the three-point shot and you can score. You've always got a chance. 9 threes now for the Orlando Magic. They've made 6 more threes, so they're plus 18 at the three-point line. And you can see when they've made 9 or more in the playoffs, they are undefeated. Let's see if that holds true again tonight.
And in fact, during the regular season, when they hit 9 or more, they're 44-11. Sometimes stats do not have significance, but that one does. James has to force it. Rebounded by LeBron. West for three. Varejao tried to draw the foul as Lewis boxed him out. So Orlando with a chance to take the lead for the first time.
Interesting, they have LeBron right now guarding Michael Petrus, and down the lane, all that screen roll game. So Ilgauskas has a tough time playing that pick and roll. He just does not have the lateral foot speed. So they're having Dwight Howard set the screen there, and Cleveland is really struggling trying to defend it.
Courtney Lee has given the Magic a 2-point lead. Williams with his first bucket in quite some time, and the game is tied at 86. 5 minutes remaining, fourth quarter. Orlando trying to take a 2-0 lead in this best of seven. Cavaliers seeking to tie the series at one apiece, and a foul is called on Varejao.
You see Courtney Lee this time. Actually, it was Varejao on that screen roll. It was not Ilgauskas, but what happened was he was not going to help off of Rashard Lewis. So So the easy shot for Courtney Lee, and then Mo Williams follows up with a medium range jumper. He's now 5 of 17 from the floor after being 6 of 19 in game one.
Cavaliers with 3 team fouls, Orlando with 2. Lewis's shot blocked by Verja. Williams driving on the floor, look out. It's a blocking foul on Lewis, and he's hurt.
Looks like that Mo Williams is holding the back of his right leg. I don't know if he's cramping or if he hurt his hamstring, but he is down on the floor.
West involved in the collision with Lewis, who committed the foul. Now Ilgauskas helping Williams back to his feet.
Watch here, Mo Williams, as he goes down on the floor. What happens there? And you see right in the face, Rashard Lewis, the collision right there, right the elbow, right into the jaw of Rashard Lewis. Wow. Talked about the intensity of the playoff games and how these athletic trainers earn their money. How many bodies have we seen on the floor tonight?
Orlando with a 13-4 run, able to take the lead briefly just a moment ago. 86 apiece. Here's Williams for three. Yes! Mo Williams with a deep three to give the Cavaliers an 89-86 lead.
Marv, I told you somebody was going to have to make a jump shot. I thought it was Mo Williams. That was the biggest shot of the playoffs for him so far.
Nice crossover by Turgulu, and he scores. Hito Turgulu.
Well, they get you in all these mismatches. You know, when you've got a guy like Hito Turkoglu who can play pick and roll with that size, he puts so much pressure on you. I had Grant Hill in Detroit who did that, and he was so hard to guard.
Ilgauskas. Yes. So both clubs hitting shots here down the stretch. Cavaliers 91, the Magic 88, just under 4 left in this fourth quarter. Defending on Turgulu, goes right at him, and it's an offensive foul.
That's a good call. He gets his right arm away from his body. Barajal running right next to him. Watch his right arm as he veers into him. Now, Barajal is a great actor. There's no question about that. But watch here his right arm as he veers out right there and steps through him. They switched the screen that time, and Barajal had the ability to move his feet and stay with him.
Here's James kicking it out to West. Trying to give it back, and it's broken up.
Excuse me, Marv. This is where they hit you with threes. This is where you got to be careful.
I believe. Rebound handled by Barajal. We're down to 3 minutes to play in this fourth quarter. Cavaliers in possession, and they lead by 3. James now played by Petras. Williams open for 3. Back top by Barajal. Ilgauskas to the floor. Try to call for time. Did he get it? Well, they were granted the timeout.
How about the guys diving on the floor? Zabunas Ilgauskas, Dwight Howard, about Z, a guy who missed almost 4 years with foot injuries. Nobody knew if he was going to be able to play again. He fought back. One of the most popular players here in Cleveland. Going to give his team a chance for another possession. Big play by Big Z.
Well, both the Magic and the Cavaliers with a foul to give. The Magic, good shape in terms of timeouts. Cavaliers with just one timeout remaining. And Doug, as we come down to the final minutes of this game, no hesitation on the part of both teams to take shots, and both teams hitting shots.
Well, I like what Cleveland has done. I mean, LeBron has penetrated. You've seen Mo Williams knock down a three, even though he's only 1 of 6 from three. He ends up shoots another one. Zabunas Ilgauskas knocked down a jump shot. And then on the other end, you've seen Courtney Lee drive that ball into the basket and look to shoot the basketball. So, you know, you get an open shot, you got to take it, and you got to take it with confidence. And really, both teams are doing that right now.
2 minutes, 45 seconds to go. And the fourth quarter, Cavaliers in possession after that dive on the floor for the loose ball by Ilgauskas, who was able to be recognized on the timeout call. Williams played by Alston. West guarded by Turkoglu. Turkoglu with five fouls. They double up on James. Now Petras defending James. Petras able to poke it away. Shot clock down to five. Here's LeBron putting a move on Petras. Gets it to Ogauskas for three. And it's rebounded by Howard.
Sabonis made 15 of those in the regular season, but I think if you're going to pick something right now from Orlando, you would live with him shooting a three and keep James out of the lane.
They're chasing down Turkoglu. There's Petras. Beautifully done by Michael Petras.
Well, this is what we thought we were going to have. Two minutes to go. A one-point game.
Staying on James. Williams got the step, the runner. Oh, Williams with another key shot to give the Cavaliers a three-point lead.
Well, that's why they went out to get him, because he could get his shot off the dribble. That's a tough floater in the lane under pressure.
Williams, 19 points, 8 of cut here on the fourth. Here's Willis for three. Rebounded by Ogauskas. Rashard Lewis, the hero for the Magic in game one, looking to tie it with that three-point shot. We're down to a minute and 15 to go in the fourth. Cavaliers with the ball and a three-point lead. Shot clock at six. The alley-oop broken up on a foul. Delonte West throwing the lob. And LeBron James took that shot. Foul on Petras, his fourth.
That's a high-risk play under pressure. LeBron's going to look for the lob, and Michael Petras is going to bump him off the play right there. Actuality, Dwight Howard would have been there to knock that away, but you don't know that when you're playing LeBron. The last thing you want him to do is get a dunk. Michael Petras gets his body into LeBron James and knocks him out of the play. Loose ball foul. Nobody's shooting free throws yet.
Fourth team foul. That's a non-shooting affair. Shot clock at 10. James with the cut. Knocked away by Petras. Crowd wanted a foul. Alston for Turkoglu. Here's Lewis. And he pushes it back to Turkoglu for three.
Oh, my.
Oh. The game is tied at 93.
Oh, my. Whoa.
We're down to 40 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Williams, Howard knocked it away, and it ends up out of bounds. Last touch by the Magic.
And Dwight Howard, now you've got the defensive player of the year guarding the basket right now. And his job is right now is to allow no layups. Nobody can come in and lay that ball in the basket. Actually, Rafer Alston tried to save that ball, but he was out of bounds when he jumped in the air to knock it back in. That's why they keep possession with 9 seconds on the shot clock.
There's LeBron going at Howard. It's a travel. The basket will not count. Traveling violation called on James. The ball back to Orlando. The Magic will take a timeout.
Well, again, the presence of Dwight Howard. That's the extra step.
And once again, Michael Petras, a factor both at the offensive and defensive end.
Well, he funnels him into Dwight Howard, who knocks that ball loose. And then this is where the Magic, when they get you scrambling and they make that extra pass, you see there's nobody even in the same area code right there when Turkoglu takes that shot. They spread you out. Turkoglu has been their big game shooter. Remember the three he hit against Philadelphia to win that game on the road? This guy loves big shots. He's not had a great year, Marv, shooting the ball. When you look at his numbers and his stats, but interestingly enough, he's a better player on the road than he is at home in the playoffs.
That game six against Boston did not shoot well, but hit that mammoth three-pointer with about a minute and a half to play. And Hedo with 19 points, 14 of the 19 in the second half. Cavaliers really hurting themselves. They've turned it over six times in this fourth quarter. Orlando with just two turnovers in the quarter and both on offensive fouls. 30 seconds to go in the fourth. The game is tied at 93, and the Magic will put it in play in their front court.
And you look at the matchups, they have Varejão on Pietras, they have Pavlovich on Turkoglu, and they have LeBron on Rashard Lewis. So they're thinking if Turkoglu runs a screen roll with Rashard Lewis, they will just switch that.
Cleveland does have a foul to give. 6 second differential between the game clock and shot clock. Wallace jumps out on Turkoglu. Lewis, shot clock down to 7, Turkoglu. And a foul is called. It is on Pavlovich, appeared to be before the shot attempt. So it's a non-shooting foul. The next foul will put the Cavs over.
Yeah, but that's a bad foul, Marv, because now they're going to get the last shot of the game.
Timeout.
There was a 6.5 second differential. That clock was winding down. They were going to have to take a tough shot. Now the clock is off, and Orlando's got the last shot to win the game. He's going to drive to the basket. He gets a beat a little bit there, but he takes that foul. I mean, Turkoglu was going to be taking a tough shot there. Now the shot clock is turned off. The next foul is a shooting foul, and Orlando now can hold for the last shot to win the game.
Let's take a look back at some of the keys that you presented right at the start of the telecast.
Well, the storyline, we talked about the Magic and how deadly they are behind that three-point line in the second half. One of the reasons they've caught up their plus 15. The matchups, the Magic starting front court, 52 points and 25 rebounds after a very, very slow start. The Magic bench plus 12 tonight, and then the mindset. How would Orlando play if they got behind? Well, you know what? They got down by 23. Would they fight back? Have they fought back? The answer is yes, and they have the ball with the last shot with a chance to put this up a 2-0 lead, and both of them on the road. This possession is gigantic.
Orlando has had the lead tonight for about 30 seconds on that shot by Courtney Lee. They were up 86-84. They kept coming, down by as many as 23, and now, as you mentioned, have an opportunity to work the clock down and come up with another stunner here in Cleveland.
And the guy who normally takes this shot is Hedo Turkoglu, that's their guy. We'll see who they put on him. Are they going to put Pavlovich on him? Or are they going to put LeBron James on him?
I have to readjust the clock. It went down to 0, and I see it's at 13 minutes remaining, but obviously they have to make an adjustment.
Well, this is one of the reasons why the LeBron James to talk about the importance of Pavlovich in a game like this, because you have to match small now. You cannot play two big guys. So they'll put Varejão and Michael Pietras and hide him on him, and they'll put Ben Wallace on Dwight Howard.
So 13.7 remaining in the fourth quarter. How do they play it if the ball goes into Howard down low?
Well, you better not give him a dunk or a layup. You better take the foul if you're in trouble. And if you double team, you worry about the three-point shot. So take a look to see here how they're going to match up.
30-second official timeout.
And they are still having some difficulty in adjusting that clock. And again, athletic trainer Max Benton taking care of the blood on the right leg of LeBron James.
Like Dr. Ferdy Pacheco.
Max getting a lot of camera time here tonight.
Remember that unfortunate incident that happened? Obviously, you don't have this same kind of situation. Remember Steve Nash, how he got his nose bloodied in game one against the San Antonio Spurs? They couldn't get it stopped. The Spurs won that game and went on and won that very controversial series with the suspensions and all that went on. So very important for him to get that blood stopped so he could stay on the court.
Rashard Lewis will look to throw it in. LeBron James defending on the inbound.
And Marv, remember now, that throw-in is no given. We saw the other night when Ariza stole the pass against Denver and sealed the game. So this is to make sure that they trust that Rashard Lewis can get this ball in under pressure.
Orlando does have a 20-second timeout remaining. Cleveland has a full timeout left. Both teams over the foul limit. Lewis gets it in. Turkoglu, played by Pavlovich, down to 10 seconds. The game is tied at 93. We're down to five. Down to three. Here's Trocolo. Yes! With 1 second remaining. Cleveland calls for time. And the Magic with a 95-93 lead. Another clutch shot by Mr. Fourth Quarter. The Q, a very quiet arena. Following that jump shot by Hito Turkoglu to give the Magic a 95-93 lead. Cavaliers just called their final timeout with 1 second to play in this fourth quarter.
Now what you want to do, Marv, is you want to put all kind of pressure on the ball and force Cleveland to have to catch the ball going away from the basket, catch and fire a very difficult shot. They might try some kind of lob to the basket. You've got to be prepared to switch so they can't get anything. What you want, everything going back towards half court.
Mo Williams will throw in. Rashard Lewis playing off the ball. Lewis gets it to LeBron for three for the win. Yes! LeBron James at the buzzer as the Cavaliers have pulled it out to tie the series. And what a miraculous shot by James! LeBron James off the inbound. That's his first three-pointer of the night. How about this as a follow-up to the clutch shot by Hito Turkoglu? And the Cleveland Cavaliers, after blowing a 23-point lead, are indeed fortunate to come away with a incredible victory.
Well, Mark, you said, I told you, you wanted that ball going away from the basket. They forced him away. He caught it and made an incredible shot. That's what MVPs do. Those kind of shots. And a shot like that can turn a whole series around. Instead of being down 2-0, you're now 1-1, riding an incredible momentum down to Orlando for game three.
They did review the shot to make certain he got it off on time. Get the official word. Monty McCutcheon, the basket is good. Let's go to Craig with LeBron James.
Well, LeBron, just an incredible finish. We talked about the pressure in this arena. Hito Turkoglu puts them up. You only have 1 second left. How did you maintain your composure? What kind of shot attempt do you think you're going to get?
Hey, Craig, man, we just couldn't afford to go down 0-2 in this series, going into Orlando. Once again, Orlando kept their composure, being down, and made a run, man. And, man, that's just a great shot, man. You know, we got to get ready for game three. That's a great shot, but we got a lot to clean up.
You and Hito were matched up during those great shots at the end of the game. What were your thoughts when he made his?
Wow. And I've seen it before. Hito has, he's hit big shot after big shot in the playoffs in the regular season. I had to match him shot for shot, man. And Rashard Lewis hit a game-winning three, game one, and I matched him with a game-winning three in game two.
Marv called it. He said it's a good three, but obviously the officials had to review it. How nervous were you watching the replay, wondering whether or not
I knew it was good, but you never know. And the camera never lies, so I had to go check it out, man. And it was a good shot, man, good shot.
The series is now tied, but you go to Orlando. What can you do differently to stop giving away these big leads?
It's a very good team. We gotta keep our composure, and we gotta stop allowing them to make easy and open opportunities. We're blowing coverages a lot on the defensive end, which is unacceptable. And anytime you blow a coverage against a team that execute that well, they're gonna make you pay for it. And we did that once again tonight. We gotta clean that up.
You obviously wanted to go to the basket throughout that second half. It seemed like you were getting a little tired. Your legs maybe giving out. You had a traveling call with 30 seconds left that you didn't argue. How tired were you getting?
You got to fight through it. Everybody at this position in the playoffs is tired. Great call by the refs. It was definitely a travel. but I'm glad I was able to redeem myself for my teammates.
Well, Hedo quieted this crowd with 1 second to go in the game, but they're not quiet now. MVP, congratulations.
Thanks, Craig.
Back to you, Mark.
All right, thank you, Craig. An extraordinary finish to a game that will be considered a classic because of the duel down the stretch in the fourth quarter.